All right, so I got the S7 elbow arm, whatever you want to call it, right? This is the piece where if I have the S7 and I'm trying to do astros or look at high angles, I can put this on. It gives me an elbow to look down through. So a problem we've been running into with these is you look through it and you can't see crosshairs once you put it on the instrument. So it's one of two things happening. Either dust and moisture is getting inside this tube because it's not sealed, or the lens right here, there's a lens in there, it's coming loose and it's going sideways and you can't see the crosshairs. It doesn't let you focus in the instrument. So what I got here is a little quick fix, something that we shouldn't really have to do. I don't really necessarily recommend doing this, but if you're in a pinch and you need to get this to work, this way you can do, and you're using things from around the office basically. So what I got some silicone. It's preferably used clear. I got white stuff. As long as it don't get on the lens, it should be fine. And if I mess up, I can just wipe it off. It's silicone after all. I got a little pen or a mechanical pencil. All I'm using is the eraser to apply the silicone. It helps me out. I got a binder clip. What I'm actually using from this is the handle. So I can get that out of here. And then I got some sort of pliers. Okay. I'm just using a Gerber. So first things first, I'm going to take this guy, I'm going to take off the eyepiece, and I'm going to take off, I just take the eyepiece off, that'll be alright. Then you'll see this piece right here is threaded in, so that's why I get the pliers, and all I simply do, gently undo it. It's very fine threading. All right, so see, it's off now. Set that down, put it to the side. A little spring comes out, doesn't matter what way it goes in, doesn't appear to. Set that to the side. And now there's a little plastic tube in there that you can't really see. But what I'm gonna do, that's why I got this. Helps me reach in there and pull it out. All right. Now I get that all the way out, and there's that lens I'm talking about. This lens is what's actually inside here coming loose. So if I do this, give it a little tap, a little shake, and I look at it, you can actually see the lens is free floating. See how it's coming out like that? It shouldn't be doing that. And that's what's causing these problems. So what I'll do, try to get it out as gently as possible. Might even use this again. There we go. The lens is out. All right, so as far as the lens goes, try to pay attention to what way it came out so you can put it back in the same direction. If you mess it up and you look through and you can't see the crosshairs after you're done, then you simply take it apart and put it in the other way, okay? So what I'll do is I'll take it. I got some microfabric here. Clean it off while I'm in here. I can visually check inside the tube. If I take this cap off, you'll see some light. So if you look in here, at this point, I can get some Q-tips or something, clean out the inside if I need to, if that's the problem. And then if I need to get to the other side, this part will also screw off. So I can hit both sides of that lens on the end. Okay, and I can even clean the adapter off if I need to, but this thing's pretty pristine. So I'll put that back into place. It's not dirty. No moisture. Nice and snug. All right, so now back to the lens. I clean it off on both sides. Take my silicone. Just need a little bit. I can apply this to the edges. Make sure you're not getting it on the face of the lens, just on the edges. If you get a little bit, it's all right. It should still be working. All right, about a little dab will do you. You kind of see that? Got it on the edges. Trying not to touch the face. You might want to use rubber gloves if you have them available. So now I'll take this, put it back in the tube. Trying not to touch it with my hands. Get it to seat back into place. If you're listening, you hear it click in. There. So now I'll get some access, the excess silicone off. You see it's applied to the edges, so it should, once it cures, it should hold it pretty steadily. So now you do one of two things. You can leave it out, let it cure, or what I've been doing, I've just been putting it right back in and it'll dry on its own. But so I take it lens first. Goes back into the tube. It's a tight fit. Okay. Don't need to pack it down, but I'll make sure it seats completely in. It's in there. I look through. The lens has not came loose, so it's good. I'll proceed. Take the spring. Put that back into place. This piece that I took off with the pliers can go back in. I'll use the pliers to snug it up real gently. Now it's back on. It's assembled. I'll put the eyepiece on. And if you want to let this cure, you just sit it down like this. Let it do its thing. You're just trying not to really jar it or hit it while it's curing so that the lens doesn't come loose again and then dry like that. So now if I test it, bring the S7 over. Put the elbow back on. Alright, so now if I take it and I look inside, crosshairs, there they are. So nice dark crosshairs back into place. Crosshairs back into place. It works. It's good. It's a quick fix. I recommend you go through your supply section, you order new ones, you put in a work order to Mictissa or Trimble, call them, let them know that these things are failing. So again, these have not been heavily used at all. Some of these were pulling out of the box for the first time and they're already broken, basically. They're broken. They're unusable. So if you got any questions, let me know.